Good evening and welcome to Movies with Maurice. I am Maurice, and tonight we have a special treat for you. The famous French classic, Le cerveau qui ne voulait pas mourir, or as it was translated into English, The Brain That Would Not Die. Actually, the title is a little bit misleading, because if you really wish to cause a brain to die, there are many methods at your disposal. Strangling the brain is a little messy, but the hammer, tuck tuck, on the brain, very effective. Actually, what we have is a doctor, a brilliant but ruthless surgeon, who wishes to keep the brain alive. We have the brain who wishes to die. We have a crippled lab assistant who wants new arms and hates the brain. We have a creature in a closet made up of amputated limbs who wants to kill the doctor and loves the brain. We have the brain who hates the doctor, although it used to love him because it is his former fiancé when it had a body. A complex and interwoven plot. But bring out the popcorn and see for yourself The Brain That Would Not Die, this week's film on Movies with Maurice. Good evening and welcome to Movies with Maurice. I am Maurice, and tonight we have a delightful treat for you, the great French film classic, Le cerveau qui ne voulait pas mourir, or as it was translated into English, The Brain That Would Not Die. Now what we have in this film is a doctor, a brilliant but ruthless young surgeon, who wishes to keep this brain alive. We have the brain who wants to die. We have a crippled lab assistant who wishes to have new arms and hates the brain. We have a creature in a closet made up entirely of amputated limbs who wishes to kill the doctor and loves the brain. And we have the brain who hates the doctor, although it used to love him when it was married to him. No, when it was his former fiancé, I'm sorry. And it also had a body at the time, of course. Anyways, it's a complex and interwoven plot in this 1963 film, so see for yourself, The Brain That Would Not Die, this week's film on Movies with Maurice.